Get ready to match the star, Artie Johnson, Brett Summer, Charles Nelson Reilly, from Busting Loose, Barbara Rose, Richard Dawson, and Patty Doyle, as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 77. And now, here's the star of Match Game 77, Gene Rayburn.
Thank you for joining us here, dear friends. You're going to have a good time because we've got a bunch of witty people here today. And gifted and attractive and beautiful people.
Wealthy.
How are you? Yeah, her roots are just as red as your roots. Oh, your roots need a little touching up, though.
Well, don't you be the one to touch them.
Okay. Let's say hello to two players, Susan Stewart and Don Barry. Susan is our current champ. She has a total of $1,200 to her credit. And she was being challenged by Don Barry, who has a mind like a steel trap. Except the spring sprung. And we went to a tiebreaker. And he matched two of our celebrities in the tiebreaker question. They each get one, as you know. And Susan will have her tie-breaking question coming up in a moment or so, and she has to match two to tie and three to win. Let's see how this game turns out right after we see about this. Here we go. Let's see what happens in the tiebreaker. Whoops. Wait a minute. Don't nobody do nothing. It's the third one. Yeah, it says tie on it, and there's only one in it, so this is it.
Who was that masked man?
Gunga Dinghy, the Indian psychiatrist, does not use a couch. Instead, he makes his patients lie on his blank. Indian psychiatrist does not use a couch. Instead, he makes his patients lie on his blank.
Oh, I love your Indian accent. I'm crazy about it.
It's the worst I've ever heard. The man up there has never been anywhere that was roughly close to any of the places. He doesn't know from any of those things.
Okay,
people.
Susan.
My people know all about it.
Gunga Dinghy, the Indian psychiatrist, does not use a couch. Instead, he makes his patients lie on his blank.
What's that thing called? I think it's from those kind of Indians. That bed of nails?
Yeah! Bed of nails. She said a bed of nails, Artie.
The Gunga Dinghy is what it was, what Gunga Dinghy.
Yes.
In Indian we say Hahawardili.
Hahawardili?
Hahawardili, what you say.
Hahawardili?
Bed of nails.
Oh, a bed of nails. Score is now 2-1. Show us your bed of nails.
Well, I didn't say, I used the technical term for bed of nails.
What is that?
Bed of nails.
Bed of nails. 2-2 to score. Another bed of nails?
No, not a kakakoi.
Stand on the blue spot, as you always do. And we'll say goodbye to John Barry.
Thank you, Gene.
Pleasure to meet you, John.
You.
Many gifts will be coming your way as a memento of your trip to Match Game 77.
Thank you.
John Barry. He's going to get lots of nice gifts, you know. Book of knowledge and all things like that. Now, Susan, we'll have another shot at it here. You pick up another $100. You got $1,300. You could win over $5,000 here if you get the smarts, and your ESP goes with one celebrity. We polled a studio audience not too long ago, and we said, write down your best answer to this. Ms. Blank. Ms. Blank. Remember, you get $500 for matching the answer they gave us most frequently, $250 for matching their second most frequent response, and for matching the third most popular answer, you get $100. And three of our six celebrities are permitted to assist by suggesting answers.
Richard.
Ms. Magazine.
Ms. Magazine.
Patty.
Now, Patty, just think about it for a second.
Ms. Ms. Gloria Steinem.
Gloria Steinem. Ms. Steinem. Okay.
Artie.
Artie, it's tough
to
be third.
Something may come to you.
An idea may come to you.
How about Ms. America?
Ms. America?
Nothing came to
me. Didn't come to me.
Ms. America, yes. So you got Ms. America, You got Ms. Gloria Steinem and Ms. Magazine. Have you thought about it? Have you got one in your own head that's different from those? You did that once before, you know.
Not this time. No, I'm going to go with Richard and Ms. Magazine.
Ms. Magazine. I tell you, if I were playing, I would choose that one, too. I can't think of another one. Can you?
No.
No. Okay, let's find out if we got a Ms. Magazine up there. May we see the $100 number? Who is she?
Not me.
Secretary.
Ira, who is Ms. Jones? Who?
No.
Somebody was in the audience that day.
The next one is Cohen. Ms. Cohen. Yes,
Ms.
She
Cohen.
Was in the audience.
She was
too.
In the audience that, too. Okay. Got an explanation for this? No. Here we go. May we see the 250 number? Ms. Steinem, Gloria Steinem, is up there, naturally. One of the leaders in the women's lib movement, one of the earliest founders. Now the last chance for Ms. Magazine. Slide it, Earl.
Yeah, you got it.
Well, you're getting there, Susan. You picked up another $500. Remember, you're going to play for 10 times that amount or $5,000, and you know what you have to do now.
Yes, I do.
What do you have to do?
I'm going to match Richard this time.
You're really going to match him this time?
I am, yes, I am.
You stop fooling around now.
Right.
You're going to get down to business.
Down to serious business.
She's down to serious business, Richard.
You've stopped fooling around?
Yeah. No. No, give her a shot at it anyway. Do your best there. Stand on the blue dot and face east.
That's the best
part. Is that east? I don't know what that is. Good luck to you. You ready? Here it is. Nanny blank. N-A-N-N-Y blank. All right, Susan, he's written his answer down. We ask you to give us an answer which matches his, and we give you the $5,000.
Nanny and the Professor.
Yeah! Nanny and the Professor. Nanny and the Professor.
We're doomed.
We're doomed?
Nanny Goat.
Nanny Goat. Nanny Goat would seem to me.
Delighted, I thought.
Yes, I said, oh, here it is, locked
in. That's a good, legitimate answer.
It is good, yes. But Nanny Goat. Nanny Goat seems to me like it would be the least common denominator. The answer that every. Did you think of it at all?
No, I was thinking of England and the girl who played in it.
Oh, yeah.
Juliet Mills.
Juliet Mills did that. Well, yeah, both grand. Two good answers again, Susan. Now we're going to introduce another player after we hear a little message from America here. Pay attention there. Here we go. Let's welcome Lynn Miller. Hello, Lynn. Where are you from?
I'm from San Diego.
San Diego, California.
I go to San Diego State University, where I'm a junior, and I'm a member of Chi Omega Sorority. And I'm a song leader for the Aztecs, and in the summer, I work part-time as an usherette at a Major League Baseball park.
Uh-huh. And you're a natural blonde.
Yes. I'm proud of it.
Yes, of course, here in California, you get so much sunshine, it keeps it bleached, doesn't it? You don't have to pour that stuff on it, do you? Yes. What are you studying in school?
I'm a liberal studies major for a degree in elementary education. I like little kids.
So do I. Okay, Lynn, good luck to you here.
Thank you.
Here we go. Round one coming up. You may have A or B.
I'll take B, please.
B it is. Lynn Miller, first round question. Barney the Butcher said,
oh.
I'll tell you why I fell in love with Ugly Edna. Her body looks like a blank.
The Butcher.
Barney the Butcher said, I'll tell you why I fell in love with Ugly Edna. Her body looks like a blank.
Got it. Oh, I'm hot today, hon.
Your mind is really working.
Oh, sweetheart, now
you cut your hair and let some air in your brains, and it's really made a big difference.
My play, it's just wonderful.
You finished your play?
I finished my play. It's wonderful. It's very funny. We hope.
Too bad you don't know any good Broadway-type directors.
I know it.
I'm busy.
Are you ready, Lynn? Okay, here we go. Barney the Butcher said, I'll tell you why I fell in love with Ugly Edna. Her body looks like a blank.
A cow?
Yeah! Well, let's see. I had a different answer in my mind, but we'll find out what happens. Artie?
You must have had my answer in mind if you had a different one, because I said, because she has a body that looked like a side of beef.
Side of beef is what I was thinking of, too. Side of beef is part of a cow, but we can't match it, Lynn.
You can't...
Can't match side of beef and cow, nope.
But it is, I mean, it is a cow in actuality. It's just a cow hanging on a hook.
Part of a cow.
Side of beef.
Two sides of beef. Listen, could we get one match for the two sides of beef? No. All right.
Ham hock.
Ham hock. It is. Excellent answer. Two sides of beef and a ham hock. What do you got?
I have the cow.
You have a cow.
Isn't that a girl?
There's one for Lynn. Barney the Butcher said, I'll tell you why I fell in love with Ugly Edna.
Huh?
Ugly Edna. That's because her body looks like a blank.
A rib roast.
A rib roast. That's ugly. What do you say to this?
You want to talk ugly?
Yeah.
Extra lean hamburger.
Ah! Extra lean hamburger. All right. Well, she got the idea, didn't she?
Mm-hmm.
You got the idea. You got $1,800. Georgie Jessel said, just pick it up from, I say, Georgie Jessel said,
I just presided over a wonderful funeral. My eulogy was so moving, the dead man blank.
I usually have to repeat it once for Brett.
Just all that wonderful funeral. My eulogy was so moving, the dead man wiped.
Blank.
I'm
blank.
Finished.
Oh. Finished.
Finished? No, I'm Swedish.
All right. Do you ever see Georgie Jessel on television?
A couple times.
You know who he is.
I'm not... Well,
he's a vaudevillian. He's been on Broadway a great deal. He's made many movies. He's done nightclubs. And he was known as the Toastmaster General of the United States. He would MC a lot of benefits. And he was a good spontaneous speaker. Georgie Jessel said, I just presided over a wonderful funeral. My eulogy was so moving, the dead man blanked.
Cried.
I think it's a moderately amusing answer myself.
Well, I'm a moderately amusing person, and I agree with her. I said cry.
Cry. 1-1 is the score. What do you say?
What did she say?
Cried.
Oh, so did I.
That's 2 for her.
Well, he went out with young girls, didn't he?
Yes, he did.
Brett used to go out with them.
With him. Of course.
Well, during the First World War. Cry.
It's oh, I'm going to get him.
It's not true, America. Georgie Jessel said, I just presided over a wonderful funeral. My eulogy was so moving, the dead man cried.
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 Cried. Or for her.
I thought the key word was moving. So I
so
said
did
the
I.
dead man walked.
Oh, yeah. I would have said the dead man, the eulogy was so moving, the dead man moved. Isn't that clever?
Mm-hmm.
Thank you.
What did you say?
I said whoops.
Whoops. Well, so there we are at the end of round 1, 4-1. You got to get your thinking cap on here, Lynn Miller. We'll see how she does right after we see about this. There. Get in there. Oh. Who was that man? That was Earl. Did he get on camera?
Yeah.
Well, as long as you got to pay you, Earl, come out and show your face properly. Earl, come out here. Take a bow. Earl the Pearl. You know what he just said? He says, I'll split the money with you. Only kidding. Here we go. Round 2 coming up. 4-1 the score. Favor the current champ. Challenger, you may have a choice of A or B.
This time I'll have A.
You want A? Okay, Lynn. Everyone except you. Tarzan say, today, me learn first law of jungle.
Yeah. Oh.
Never stand between two elephants when them blanking. Never stand between two elephants when them blanking.
Oh, when them blanking.
When them blanking.
Never stand between them.
Never stand between two elephants when them blanking.
Sure, I've got that.
Oh, it's so difficult. Now,
I was so quick up until now.
You had a part in Wombos.
Oh, yes.
Motion picture. Is that all finished shooting?
Well, I'm finished.
Your part is finished.
Yes. Choir Boys.
The Choir Boys. What a great book that was.
Excellent.
Richard read it too, didn't you?
Which part did
we
you
all
sing?
Loved that book. Which cop did you play?
I played Lieutenant Hadley.
Oh, yeah. Yes, Lieutenant Hanley.
Did you beat her?
Who wrote the music for it?
What?
The choir boy.
No, nobody wrote any music for it. Okay, Lynn, you're ready. Tarzan say, today me learn first law of jungle. Law says never stand between two elephants when them blanking.
Pottying?
Pottying? Yeah! Did you say partying?
No, I said pottying.
Pottying. Oh, making a potty. Well, either way, it would work, I suppose. Would be difficult. What do you say?
I tried that once, and I didn't grow an inch. it's from an old word used by the Ashanti called Pukupongan.
Yes.
And we call it making whoopee.
Making whoopee. Well, if she had said partying, yes, that would have matched.
She didn't say partying.
She said pottying.
Or, as we say in Indian,
Okabulama Kubuama.
Very good. I said mating.
Mating. Oh, yes. Helen, you must match the three remaining celebrities, Charles, Richard, and Patty, to stay in the game and achieve a tie. She's looking...
I said making love for peanuts.
Okay, so that makes it another game. Good luck to you and the remainder of your college career. Lynn,
Thank
it was a pleasure to meet you.
Fun.
And we'll have a lot of gifts coming your way. Lynn Miller, ladies and gentlemen, there she goes. Susan, we've got to stop meeting here like this.
Why?
In the same spot. you smell good, too. Here we go. Poll the recent studio audience. Got their best response to this. Don't fall off the stage, Ira. Blank Oak. Blank Oak. $500, remember, for matching their most popular answer. For matching their second most popular, you get $250. And if you match their third most popular, you get $100. Whom do you call on?
Richard.
Tough
Solid
one.
Oak.
Solid Oak. All right, there's one.
Brett. What you get and you scratch a lot. Poison Oak.
Poison Oak.
And Charles.
Charles, an idea will come to you sooner or later.
I got several. I'm just trying to see them, check them out as I go along, Gene. Mighty Oak.
Mighty Oak. All right. From little acorns, mighty oaks grow. That's where that comes from. Solid Oak and Poison Oak. Did you have another idea?
No.
Want one of those?
Yeah.
Which one?
Poison Oak.
Poison Oak is what we want. Let's begin down at the bottom and reveal the $100 response. Solid Oak is Richard's answer. Let's see if we get Poison Oak out of the $250 number. Live Oak. Okay.
Who's he?
Live Oak is a tree. Live Oak tree. Last chance for Poison Oak. Here we go. Slide it, Earl. There it is.
Got it. Good girl. All right.
Now remember, you're going to play for 10 times that amount or $5,000. And remember what you have to do to get it.
Brett,
here we go. Don't be nervous.
Okay. Oh, no.
Ready? Here we go. Good luck to you, my dear. It's worth $5,000. No help, if you please. Thank you. Blank Palmer. P-A-L-M-E-R. Blank Palmer. Wait a minute. You finished, Richard? The light
didn't... I'm not playing.
Oh, I mean Brett, I beg your pardon. I saw him putting it in there, and he slid the card in and pulled it on. I said, what's he doing there? Okay, Brett.
What?
Oh, I'm sorry. How does this thing go again?
Flop sweat up here. Get on with it.
Blank Palmer, P-A-L-M-E-R. Get your ESP going over to Brett, and give us the answer she has written on the card.
Arnold
Palmer. Okay, Brett. Show and tell for Arnold Palmer for $5,000.
You know what makes me feel so terrible?
Why?
Because she hasn't matched Dickie.
Yeah.
Twice, and it's and all I could think of was Betsy.
Betsy Palmer.
But I didn't say Betsy. I said Arnold. Oh!
Okay. Congratulations to her. And while she's celebrating, we got this message just for you. Gene Mabernu, join us next time on Match Game 77. Tally ho!